please stand back from the fire here? Somebody's going to get a scorched overcoat.
S'il vous plaît, on a besoin d'un peu d'espace aussi autour du feu. Alors, si vous pouvez seulement vous tasser un peu plus, peut-être. Merci.
Today we commemorate the struggles that have given us the opportunity to live in a free and democratic society. In a society where we are equals before the law without regard to sex, race, language, or means. A society in which we have inalienable rights, in which our dignity as human beings is guaranteed. May we practice what the law preaches.
Les droits inaliénables, égalité devant la loi, la garantie du respect de la dignité de l'être humain, ce sont des fondements de la société démocratique. Bienvenue à cette cérémonie toute spéciale.
Welcome also to this special moment of celebration. After nearly 7 years, the monument before us here is nearly completed, and with it a vision is becoming reality. That in the midst of our national capital, there will be a place which marks our commitment, the commitment of all Canadians, to live in a society of dignity and justice.
Ceci est un moment tout spécial.
If you look up the street to Confederation Square, you see the Tenzin Gyatso, the Dalai Lama of Tibet, the Nobel Peace Prize winner. Of love, compassion, kindness, and universal responsibility around the globe, and he lives by his words.
Le témoignage.
And the Honorable Ed Broadbent, President of the newly created International Center for Human Rights and Democratic Development.
I have brought here one of our markings and also the history of the first arrival of the people that visited us in our country. As you see on my left here, you have four seasons. On my right side, we have four colors of people in the world. And we also have four directions and then four winds. We have here the Creator and the Son and the Holy Spirit and our teachings. And we see when we first visited here, the French came here in 1534, the Indian was already here. Then the English came afterwards. But we did not know they were in conflict.
And George Wilkins, who has been the Eskimos.
climate comes from the belief that legal instruments like the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms are very important, but they are not enough in order to make sure that guarantees on paper are fully enjoyed by everyone. We need a conscious and vigilant public which can show its solidarity and its indignation when the rights of any individual, any group, or any nation are denied. Cet endroit-ci se voudra désormais un lieu de rencontre qui symbolisera the tribute resonates foremost with those who have spent years fighting discrimination or struggling for survival. Among the earliest supporters of the monument were Aboriginal, Francophone, labor, ethnocultural, religious, lesbian and gay, immigrant, refugee, and humanitarian groups representing millions of Canadians. I am proud to say that the Canadian tribute to human rights is truly a national symbol. Monsieur le Ministre, to please take back a message to our Prime Minister.
Thank you.
it is wrong. You see, sometimes we, you see, feel something, you see, uncomfortable in inside, then expecting some answer getting from outside. That's wrong. Human being, by nature, we have, I think, very good, I would say, potential, good qualities, resources there. So only question is whether we utilize these positive resources effectively or not. Then another point, you really committed in the human rights.
Please go up there if you're on that piece of blue tin circle and take your place.
Aspire to be. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Minister. On behalf of the Board of Directors, I would like to say thank you to His Holiness. I will now escort His Holiness away. He will be the first to walk through the door.
See you again.
Thank you. Hey.
Thank you.
this baby, or is she going to be out of focus here? Like, if you're this close. Yeah? Okay.
On behalf of the Board of Directors and staff of the world's first monument to human rights, it is a great honor for me to welcome you to the construction site of Canada's soon-to-be national symbol. C'est un grand honneur pour moi. It is a Canadian response to the faith and courage of a fearless man with a famous mustache and the trade union he helped found for the cause of basic rights and freedoms. The bestowing of the Nobel Peace Prize for 1983 on Lech Wałęsa was an acknowledgement that the Polish struggle belongs to the whole world. This thought was expressed by Lech Wałęsa in his Nobel Peace Prize acceptance speech and came to be our motto of the Canadian Tribute to Human Rights. We respect the dignity and rights of every human being and every nation. To follow this path means to enhance the moral power of the universal idea of human solidarity. Szanujemy godność i prawa każdego człowieka i każdego narodu. Iść tą drogą to pomnażać moralną siłę ogólnoludzkiej idei solidarności.
Over more. Over to the left.
Dear Lech, drogi Lechu. The spirit of solidarity, which has its modern roots in the vision of Mahatma Gandhi and Martin Luther King, and was incarnated by you and your fellow men and women in Poland, is today bringing down walls of division in Europe. May it help to bring down peacefully the walls that divide us in Canada. Today, with the help of your presence, Lech, the spirit of Solidarność finds a symbolic home in the world's first tribute to human rights. May it inspire us to reflection, celebration, and social action. I will ask Mrs. Shirley Carr, President of
Thank you.
tych pół interesów w Polsce i pół interesów w Kanadzie. Ksiądz mi wybaczy, jak powiem, możecie mieć dwie kochanki. Kochanka do Kanada, kochanka do Polski.
Jaruzelski musi odejść!
Thank you for coming out today. Alors on vous remercie d'être venu aujourd'hui. And we hope that you will come again.